On television, you may recall, he was doing daily battle with the press on behalf of President Bush.
Just getting organized.
Day after day at the White House, Snow was often seen mixing it up with the likes of NBC's David Gregory.
Can this report be seen as anything other than a rejection of this president's handling of the war?
You need to understand that trying to frame it in a partisan way is actually at odds with what the group itself says it wanted to do.
Are you suggesting that I'm trying to frame this in a partisan way?
Yes.
You are.
Now Snow is heading back to the airwaves as a commentator for CNN. That might surprise some people. After all, Snow spent most of his TV career at Fox News, mainly as the host of Fox News Sunday. And for Bill O'Reilly, at least, the idea of Snow defecting to CNN was unthinkable.
But you can't go over to CNN. I mean, that's the devil over there. You can't, you know, you're a religious guy. You can't go into the pagan throne over there.
But will Snow be shilling for the Republicans? Is there any difference between CNN hiring the former White House press secretary and Fox tapping Karl Rove? It all depends on how Snow is used. Fox usually puts Rove on by himself, sometimes followed by a liberal guest and sometimes not. Here he is last Sunday.
If you take a look at all the individual state polls or the Gallup tracking poll, the last month or five weeks have been good for Senator McCain.
And sometimes these TV gigs can be part of a political merry-go-round. Nicole Wallace went from the Bush White House to CBS News commentator, and this week to the McCain campaign. CNN has a tradition dating back to Crossfire of pairing Democratic and Republican analysts. And such high-profile CNN commentators as James Carville and Paul Begala worked for President Clinton. So Snow could be a valuable contributor if he's balanced by advocates for the other side, as he was this week on Larry King with former Clinton White House spokeswoman Dee Dee Myers.
But I do think that it's going to be critical for Senator Clinton at least to say to the voters, look, I'm better than this guy. I'm more experienced than this guy.
Well, absolutely.
The real question is whether Snow, who occasionally criticized Bush before joining the White House staff, will return to his roots as an independent conservative, and whether he'll stop accusing journalists of pushing political agendas now that he's one of us, sort of. Finally, last night was President Bush's final appearance at the White House Correspondents Dinner, and he passed up the opportunity to mock his media antagonist. The guy who really took some pops at the press was comedian Craig Ferguson.
My name is Craig Ferguson. I host a late-night television program for the mighty CBS Corporation. Yes. I'm their middle-of-the-night guy. And I'm kind of basically all they could afford after they finished paying Katie Couric. The New York Times, unfortunately, did not buy a table. I just want to make sure I get this right. They felt that this event undercuts the credibility of the press. It's funny, you see, I thought that Jason Blair and Judy Miller took care of that. Fox News, of course. Now, to be fair, Fox News has my favorite, the gorgeous and smoldering Bill O'Reilly. Man, that is sexy. Bill O'Reilly, who's locked in that feud with Keith Olbermann on MSNBC. The two of them are at it every night, that terrible feud. Everybody thinks they hate each other. You know what I see there? Sexual tension. That's what I say. That's a romantic comedy waiting to happen. You're the worst person in the world. You're liberal yuppie scum. Are you as turned on as I am? You bet I am, mister.
I love the band. And so I'm going to say my farewell to you by doing something I've always wanted to do.
The president living out a boyhood dream. Well, that's it for this edition of Reliable Sources. I'm Howard Kurz. Join us again next Sunday morning, 10 a.m. Eastern, for another critical look at the media. Late edition with Wolf Blitzer begins right now.